Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video we will see how we can enable passwordless authentication from a Unix server to a Iceland cluster. We can also say this like how we can enable RSA public key authentication to a Iceland cluster from Unix machine. So usually what happens if you want to log into Iceland cluster or any of its node from a Unix server, then you will have to execute command like SSH, and then you have to give the IP address of any one of the node or the smart connect zone name FPDN, and it will ask you a password. Once you enter the password, you will be able to log into the Iceland cluster. But what if you don't want to give the password? A scenario may come where you have a script in the Unix server and you don't want to mention the passwords anywhere in the Unix server. In that scenario, passwordless authentication is very helpful. So let me show you what I mean exactly with that. So I am in a Unix server, and if I execute command SSH and then the IP address, it will prompt me for a password. And once I give the password for that particular Iceland node, it will allow me to log in here, and then I can execute any command from here. But I don't want to give that password. In this scenario, you will have to use the RSA public key authentication. Now, before proceeding further, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you always get notification about this kind of video from my channel. So the first step would be here is to generate a RSA public key. So the concept here is that you will have to generate a public key in the Unix server, and then you will have to add that public key in the authorized key files of the Iceland node. So first, in Unix machine, you will have to create a public key, and to do that you will have to execute command ssh-keygen. So hit enter, and it will ask you for a file in which you want to save the key. So I will use the default. So make a note that this is the key file, the file will be stored in this particular location. Now if you want to give any other path, then specify the path here, otherwise it will take the default from this prompt. Hit enter. It is asking for a passphrase. You can give a passphrase, else you just enter and it will proceed without a passphrase. Once again, it's asking for the passphrase that you have given in the previous steps. If you have not given, then just hit enter and it will skip. Now the public key has been saved in this particular location. Now make a note that id underscore rsa and id underscore rsa dot pub. So dot pub has the public key, and id underscore rsa is the private key. You don't want to share the private key to anyone. You just have to get the public key here. So let's read the public key here by executing the command cat and that path. Now this is your public key. Now we want this public key to be added in the Iceland node. Now we'll have to go to the Iceland cluster here. First of all, you'll have to decide for which Iceland user you want to enable the passwordless authentication. If you want to enable it for the root, then you'll have to find the home directory of the root in the Iceland. And if you want to enable it for any other users, for example admin, for example FTP or any other user, then you will have to get the home directory. If I want to enable the authentication for root user in Iceland account, then just execute isi auth users view and root, and this command will give you the home directory of the root user. So in this case I have slash underscore root. Now what if I want to enable the authentication for a admin user or some any other user? So you just have to give here admin, and it will give us the home directory of that particular user. Now as we want to enable it for root account, then this is the home directory. So you just have to log in and you just have to verify if few directories are already exist or not. And what is that? I will tell you in a minute. Now here you have to make sure that .ssh directory exists or not. If it does not exist, then you can create it by executing command mkdir dot ssh. Now, as it is already exist, I don't have to do anything here. Now go inside dot ssh directory, and here you will have to make sure that you have a file called authorized key. If you do not find the authorized key file here, then you will have to create it by executing command touch and the authorized key file. So as the file already exists, I don't have to do anything. Now go back to your Unix server and copy this particular public key. Once you copy it, go back to your ISLAN, and here you will have to paste that public key in authorized key file here. Now once you done with this, the setup is completed. Now you can go back to the Unix machine and execute the same command ssh and the fqdn or the IP address of the node under which you have added the public key. And in now we have observed that it didn't ask any password to us. It directly prompted us to the ISLAN node, that is node 2. Now if you will use it for the node 1 IP, then it will fail, because this authorized key files is only exists in the node 2. If you want to enable it for node 1, then you will have to log into the node 1 here. And once you log into the node 1 here, then again you will have to go to dot slash root slash dot ssh slash. So we don't require slash here, this is the directory, and here you will have to find out whether the authorized key file exists or not. If it exists, then you will have to perform the same steps that has been done on node 1. Once you do that, then only you will be able to access node 1 from this Unix server without using password. So hope this video was helpful to you. Let me know in the comment section if you have any queries or any questions on this. And once again, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.